Hello, you beautiful, beautiful people. I am Peyton Royce, and you're about to watch the handsome Christian, aka Unsible 1047. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to become iconic.
Go to WrestlingFigureShop.com for all your WWE and AEW action figure needs and use discount code UNSTABLE at checkout to save yourself 10%. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, you beautiful, beautiful people. Welcome back to another video. I hope you all are having a fantastic day. If you could please go ahead and hit that thumbs up button, I would really appreciate it. I've got a very, very exciting video for you guys today. In today's video, we are basically going to be predicting the next few Ultimate Edition lines. And I got to give a shout out to my boy. You guys should know the drill by now. Shout out to Anonymous _ Figure Collector on Instagram. How many times have we shouted out Anonymous the past few months, guys? He has just been killing it. He has been given so many video ideas. It's not even funny. But guys, this video has been in the making. I'm not joking, for about 2 months now. We were on FaceTime like 2 months ago for this specific video. He's always giving me ideas, and this one should have been made a long time ago, should have been on YouTube, but I just been slacking, and I do apologize about that. But basically, we're going to be predicting, and how it's going to work. This is what we have. We have 4 current men, 4 current women, 4 legend women, and 4 legend men. So this is kind of like obvious, I guess you could say, because look at the Ultimate Edition lines. You basically have, you know, the top women and the top guys in it. You know, we got Ronda Rousey, you know, we got Brock Lesnar, Triple H, Shawn Michaels, Finn Balor. We just have basically the top guys. So it's kind of obvious who's going to be in the line. You know, for an example, we have Rock and Charlotte. We have Hollywood Hogan and The Fiend coming out. So for example, they're not going to go ahead and make an Akira Tozawa into the Ultimate Edition line. So what we did is basically we're going the safe route and picking the top guys for this video. So again, shout out to Anonymous Figure Collector. When we were on the phone, we both made a list, and his list ended up winning, of course. So we're basically gonna be going, well, we did have some of the same answers, but let's just say he had a better list than me. And thank you, Anonymous, for everything you do. First up on the list, we're going with the Monday Night Messiah, Seth Rollins. I almost forgot his name for a second. That's ridiculous. You know, many attires we could choose from. As we know, in the fan takeover line, we have 3 options possibly coming out for Seth Rollins Ultimate Edition. They could do many different attires, but we know Ultimate Editions are awesome. For example, they could do his WrestleMania 36 attire. You know, they could do it with his black jacket with the fur on it. There's just so many options for Seth Rollins, but he is kind of obvious. Next on the list, I know a lot of you guys are going to be upset at me, but again, we got to look at it from the safe route, what most likely potentially could happen, and that is Roman Reigns. You know, nothing too exciting about a Roman Reigns. I know he really doesn't change, you know, same black vest, you know, it's just going to be basically a Roman Reigns as an Ultimate Edition. Nothing too exciting for me. You know, I haven't got a Roman Reigns in I don't know how long. It just, they're basically all the same to me, so I really don't need a Roman Reigns. Next up, another one which is kind of obvious is the man AJ Styles. Again, another person who has several attires. He's in so many elite lineups, so it's basically like a certain that he's gonna end up in the Ultimate Edition line. You know, he has some great attires, don't get me wrong, his elites are awesome, but there's just been so freaking many, it's not even funny. He's always shelf forming, whether it be a basic, an elite, he's always on the shelf no matter what store you go into. But they have so many attires to choose from. Now, I might sound like a hypocrite here, because Jeff Hardy is another one who has so many freaking elites, but I will say to the day I die, make Jeff Hardy in every single wave. I will buy every single one because that's how much I love Jeff Hardy. And Jeff Hardy, you really can't complain about, because he has so many different unique face paints, attires. It's just so many endless opportunities, and I think Jeff Hardy would be the greatest Ultimate Edition Mattel makes, and I would put my life on the line before Jeff Hardy leaves. Please make him into an Ultimate Edition. Now on to the women. Asuka, she definitely has to be in this line, because if you guys remember, in which line was it? The Target exclusive, the network spotlights, we were supposed to get that Asuka, and it was supposed to come with the role. Before that, it was supposed to be the WrestleMania Elite. Basically, what I'm trying to say, we need an Asuka with a robe, Mattel, and this is the only way you could get Asuka with a robe. Since it's more money, put her in the Ultimate Edition line, and plus, Asuka elites are awesome, and so Asuka's just just awesome. Next up on the list, we have a Sasha Banks. Yes, she does have an Elite coming out, but for example, guys, just because they have figures coming out doesn't mean they can't be in every single line. Example, AJ Styles, Finn Balor, Johnson, you know, basically, we'll just say AJ Styles. But Sasha Banks, you know, she has many, many great attires. A lot of people love Sasha Banks. It would be a popular figure, definitely. So why not get Sasha Banks in the line? I mean, it would be smart on Mattel's end. You know, for an example, like I said with the Akira Tozawa, they're not going to make a Dana Brooke Ultimate Edition. Next up, we have Bayley. You know, Bayley is scheduled for an upcoming Elite, but like I said before, guys, they're going to be in multiple lines. They're the top people in the company right now, so it's the only thing that would make sense. And Bayley has many, many unique attires. It could come with the women's champion, the tag team champion, just so many options they have, you know, the shorter hair, and again, multiple attires. We haven't got a Bayley figure in quite some time, so it would only make sense. Next up on the list, kind of the same thing, Rhea Ripley. We have an Elite figure of her coming out, but how awesome would it be, I should say, if we got her WrestleMania attire in the Ultimate Edition line. Beautiful attire. Rhea Ripley is amazing, coming with the NXT Women's Champion, the pants, the vest, everything about her would be absolutely insane. Again, another one of the top women in WWE/NXT, so it would make sense. Again, Ultimate Edition lines, they take a while because there's only a few a year. It's not like the regular Elites. Next up on the list, a Macho Man Randy Savage. Ooh, yeah, I can't do it anything like him. But again, we have gotten several Macho Man Elites in from Mattel. And again, he's a legend. Everyone would love another Macho Man. And you could imagine the detail in, you know, the jackets, the attire. It would be beautiful. Let's just say that. And I know Mattel can knock it out of the park. And I think out of the park, and people would go absolutely crazy. Again, we have The Rock Ultimate Edition coming out, so it would only make sense if we got a Stone Cold in the Ultimate Edition line. You know, I could just imagine how awesome a Stone Cold would look. You know, it's crazy. We don't get that many Stone Colds. I know he didn't change that many times. You know, it's the jean shorts, the vest, you know, but we need more Stone Cold Elites. I don't care. Stone Cold is freaking amazing. He's a legend. He is awesome. Mattel, keep making Stone Cold Elites. I'm not going to complain about it. Next up on the list, we have The Undertaker. Now, we have gotten many flashbacks, many current Undertaker figures. We have got this Undertaker, you know, with the shirt down to the pants in a basic line, but never in an Elite line. And I just think that would be so, so dope if we got Undertaker in the Ultimate Edition line with the shirt, you know, down like that. There's many options for Undertaker too, but that's just one that comes to mind. There's several others, but I mean, it's Undertaker. Next up on the list, we have Kane. You know, I don't care. Kane, just give me the attire on the screen 30 times in every single Elite wave. I wouldn't have complained, because that Kane was absolutely badass. You know, we do have the Survivor Series 2000, what was it, 2002 Kane, I think, coming out with the, you know, the lighter color. I forgot to mention that in video for what we will see at San Diego Comic-Con. I apologize for that. The Survivor Series ones, but Kane. Gotta get Kane. Next up on the list, we have the Legend Women. Of course, you gotta add Lita onto the list. You know, they don't make too many flashbacks of the women, which is a shame. Of course, you gotta be on a Legends line, so a Legends contract, so I understand it to a degree. You know, we got Lita not that long ago, but I mean, Lita had many attires, this for sure, with the Women's Champion. A great way to get the Women's Champion in the line again. You know, it's Lita. She's awesome. She's amazing. Have that little thong sticking out. It would be absolutely beautiful. You can't go wrong. Next up on the list, basically another guarantee, Trish Stratus. Oh my god, and probably everyone's favorite, Trish Stratus. You know, many attires again. You know, she could come with the Women's Champion. You know, she could come with the cowgirl hat. She could, it would be beautiful, guys. I mean, let's be honest, it would be absolutely beautiful. And we haven't gotten an Elite of Trish, or Trish, I should say. I was gonna say Lita, but I just said we didn't get one that long. We got one a little while ago from her, but we haven't got one from Trish in quite some time. We did get that battle power pack for her and Lita, but it's not an Elite. Next up on the list, we have Stephanie McMahon. Of course, we have that beautiful Triple H Ultimate Edition. So let's make a Stephanie from around that time frame so we could put it with that Triple H. I know people would not be upset with a flashback Stephanie McMahon. You know, Jax definitely provided us with flashback Stephanies, but they were around during that time and they were making it, so I guess they weren't really flashbacks. They were kind of current, but they still made them and they were awesome. I just want a flashback Stephanie McMahon, and this one is probably everyone's favorite. Chyna from WrestleMania, my favorite attire she's ever wore. Please, I am begging you, come out with, you know, with that the little machine gun, you know, the women's champion. Just give us more Chyna figures and Mattel. No one will get hurt. I'm not making it there. I'm just kidding. Don't demonetize me, YouTube. I'm sorry. I'm not going to hurt anyone. But please, I know you're making more Chyna figures, but you have to make this attire. Please, Mattel, I will do things with you. I will do anything you want. Just make that attire. But guys, that's gonna do it for today's video. I'm pretty confident that we had some great ones on the list. Let me know what you think. Let me know who you would have in the Ultimate Edition line. You guys know everything to say down in the comment section below. But if you enjoyed this video, if you could please go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. If you are a new viewer, please subscribe for more. I love each and every one of you, and I will see you beautiful people next time. Flocka gang, gang squad 100 squad.